Hi guys, welcome to this video, which is going to be a weekly vlog. And it's actually the first time I'm going to attempt a weekly vlog, but since this week, well, 10 days actually, it's going to be London Film Festival, and I'll be attending like some really, really awesome screenings and premieres and events and stuff like that. I thought it'd be fun to take you guys along with me and document this madness, but also exciting times. And try and put it together into a weekly vlog sort of thing. So today it is the 8th and it is Sunday, and my London Film Festival journey starts today, if you want to put it that way. And tonight I am going to screening of Pickups, which is a film by Jamie Thraves, starring Aidan Gillen. And yeah, so I'm really excited to see that because we've got tickets to see that. I'll take you guys along with me and hopefully I'll get to reunite with Aidan. And also, if you guys didn't know, if you're watching this vlog, I assume that you know, but I'm packing my little like premiere bag, if you will. This is the one I take to all the events and stuff because it's waterproof and I can chuck things that I need to get signed and stuff in there. Trying to open this and show you guys one-handed is a lot harder with a vlogging camera. And you guys probably know what we've made, all the Aidan Gillen fans come together to make this book, which is basically just a book of fan letters. As you can tell, we're all in deep mourning after the season finale of Game of Thrones, and we were kind of like, we wanted to show our appreciation basically, so we've all written something in this book. So yeah, me and Aidan Gillen on Twitter, like underscore Aidan.Gillen on Twitter, decided to start this letter project. And I'm so amazed by how many people have like actually contributed and sent in letters and fan art, because it's absolutely amazing. Like, everyone's so talented. I feel like really inferior actually, but yeah. There's hair on this, my bad. But this is the cover that I've stuck on. I've decided for more of like a vintage sort of theme, and don't know if I want to show everything on all the letters on camera, but it's amazing. That's my letter. We're not gonna look at that one, but look at that, like, wow, look at this artwork, it's amazing. Look how cute this one is. Yeah, so I'm sure, hopefully I can get it to Aidan and hopefully he will like it, because I think it's amazing. He has such amazing fans. Look at this one. This one even has Echo in it, like, so cute. And look at this one, just amazing. So yeah, fingers crossed we'll be able to get that to him. What else have I brought in here? Oh, I've also brought this magazine, which is the Esquire mag he was in, because I think I might get something from that signed. One of my favorite photo shoots ever, but the problem is I don't know which page to get signed because they're all amazing. About to leave the house now. The screening doesn't start till 8:30, but I thought I'd spend the day out and about anyway. Might go to the South Bank. Sorry, the house is a tip. I will try and not show you guys. But I'm just choosing a coat to wear. Probably gonna wear my leather jacket. Hi K2. But look at this jacket. Like, what would happen if I wore this? Like, can you imagine? Pink lips, pink. Anyway, I'll quickly run you guys through what I'm wearing today. As you can see, I'm not wearing that crazy pink coat, but I'm just wearing my trusty old Saints leather jacket over this pleated plissé polka dot Topshop wrap dress, which is pretty much probably not ideal for this weather, but I thought it'd be the black and white theme because my hair and makeup is crazy pink already. And then I've got my skinny dip bag, and then my Acne Jensen boots. In the background. I swear I always vlog on this bridge. What is this bridge called? I keep forgetting. It's not Millennium Bridge. I keep thinking it's the Harry Potter Bridge, but it's not. It's the one like next to that one. But this is the way we always... No! This is the way we always take to get to the BFI, because that's where the screening is going to be tonight. And I swear this is in my last vlog as well, but you know, the best things happen at the BFI. So.
Okay, so we're whiling away the time at the BFI here before the screening, and I come out of the toilet to see Winky doing this, which apparently is a brain exercises. Not that part, surely. How is that a brain exercise?
I don't know.
No, you have to like walk around. Yeah.
And then
see, sometimes your five fingers like this.
Spider-Man.
So and after that, tap your head and then rub your belly.
Tap my head and rub my belly.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then change. Yeah.
Tiger Girl in LFT2. We'll take a horse for that. This is the 10 minutes call for pickups in LFT1. We'll all take a horse for 8 minutes screen with pickups. Please start taking your seats now in LFT1.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah,
of course.
I've got 6 months. Yeah. I just want to get this guy to take a hand there.
Hi, Aidan. Me. How are you?
Hey, how's it going?
How are you?
Absolutely, yeah, good.
Oh my god, I can't wait to watch this.
Yeah, well.
We need hers.
Yeah.
He needs to give you something. So
okay, great.
Yeah, starting with the end is always good. Yeah, well, the reason we ended up, sounds very loud, working together in the first place, it wasn't just that particular short, but a few of the short films you'd made I had seen before we worked together on The Lowdown in 2000, and I was always intrigued by the style of those, you know, those shorts, and they were, I suppose, you know, more experimental and free form than what we got to work on The Lowdown, or even Treacle Junior, which was something we made in between on like a tiny budget. But when it came to this one, we thought, well, if we're going to be doing this, you know, just off our own bat in our houses, you know, with on extremely limited resources, why not take advantage of the fact that there's no restrictions and no limitations, and you know, why be restricted by the rules if there aren't any, and there's, you know, no one telling you what to do, you know, which could be you could also say that's a bad way when I make a film, but we enjoyed it. And as far as the writing credit that you asked for, I mean, on the Lowdown, and certainly on Treacle, there was a certain amount of improvisation going on. When we did Treacle Junior, that, you know, came out of a series of you know, workshops that we were doing, and we had like three different stories that we were trying to make, and there was actors involved that never ended up in it, and you know, there was two quite strong stories, but they were poles apart. So there was, you know, I always was involved in that way, and this time around, I mean, you know, the stuff in there, some of it's improvised, some of it's written, and the stuff that's written, he did most of the actual writing. There was a lot of this film was made in post. I mean, there's a lot of, we shot it quite fast in a couple of weeks, but a lot of, the tone of it comes from the edit, which took a long time, especially given that, you know, the stuff that we had, which wasn't, there was more of it than that, but not loads more. So it really, you know, came from the way it was put together, and a lot of it, the voiceover and all the rest of it. So it's nice to have a writing credit, but it's mostly him.
And maybe you could speak to that sense of bearing, you know, what Jamie said, that the film is both of you kind of bearing your souls to a certain extent, but in a way the pressure is more on you because you're playing a character called Aidan, who's a successful actor, and...
Yeah, I know, but I played a character called Aidan in our last film as well. So that's just the way we do things. We thought, I mean, we certainly did think it would be a good idea to make something personal, but also to have a bit of fun with that. And I kind of found in, I just mean in my life or with actors or whatever, that nowadays people are inclined to, you know, feel they have the right to, you know, pry or to just ask you all kinds of things, or that you'd be willing to just show people everything about your lives and your photographs and your Instagrams and all that stuff, which I kind of really don't like at all. But if they're pushing in that direction, you know, we'll want to just play the game a bit, but then just throw in loads of made up stuff as well, you know, just to create a kind of a smokescreen.
Can I just say it was quite
good? It was really funny the first time we shot that second scene after the opening scene, which I still cringe when I watch that opening scene. The sex murder scene. I felt very uncomfortable. But then it goes to the Aidan on the street, and I asked you, how often do you get approached in the street? We were on what part of Dublin were we on that street? What was that? And you said, well, it can vary. And so we thought, oh, we'll just leave it to chance and see what happens. So we set the camera up on the other side. It took ages before anyone came up.
Did it? I can't remember.
But we had to pay a few.
There's a lot.
There
was a lot more stuff that happened that was very interesting that we couldn't actually show, you know. But the thing about doing a personal thing and all that, you know, we had the bones of a script, and we wanted to make a film about a musician, and we thought, well, look, we'll start off and we'll start shooting in your house and my house. So we got our camera and, you know, a few people who said they were going to work on it, and we hadn't really thought this through, but like both of our houses were empty shells, like empty houses that we left, that we used to live in, that we brought our kids up in, you know, and like lots of stuff had happened since I moved out of my house for me, and so we just started shooting stuff in the house, and the stuff that was shot in your house never ended up in the film, but it just started off in this tone, which was kind of lonely and melancholic, and we didn't want to do that because we kind of, you know, reformed and we're trying to make it a comedy here. So I saw it in what we were trying to get across was that even in the everyday life of say an actor or a performer or, you know, or and lots of other professions as well, but particularly those, you're dealing with all this stuff where you're, you know, pretending to be other people and taking it, you know, incredibly seriously and almost inducing this psychosis, you know, constantly in different ways, kind of over and over, over years. That's what, you know, if you're feeling that in your everyday life, what's your subconscious like when you're asleep? It's really fucked, you know? And it started off as a kind of a, even the way we shot it and the way we were acting it, as a kind of pleasant, you know, almost very ecstatic thing. But then, you know, became something else. And it was also a bit of a joke about, you know, being even yourself showing up in your own dreams and your kind of egos fighting each other and fucking each other and killing each other and just all this shit. So you just, there's no room for anyone else, you know?
Aidan said something really funny to me, and it was a really funny line, and I tried about 100 times to try and get it into the film. And every time I put it in, I thought, oh no, it just doesn't work. But you said, I think fortunately for Aidan, he's a busy actor and employed quite a lot. So he said this really interesting line. He said, I think I end up spending spending more time being someone else than being myself. And every time I thought that's a fantastic line, and every time I tried to put it, Aidan spent more time being someone else than himself. It just sounded so pretentious. And I was just going, "What's on your alignment?" It was a really interesting idea, but every time I tried to express it, and so we just tried to do it visually rather than words.
And hopefully, a lot of that stuff does come across as pretentious, because you know. That's the way it is. Yeah. And it is.
Oh my god. Guys, we did it. Gave him the book and we also just saw the film. And what did you think about the film?
It's good.
Yeah, I saw her laughing because we were sitting in different seats because we couldn't get seats together. And she was practically sitting behind Aidan. Like, how was it sitting behind Aidan?
It was... Yeah, it was tense.
It was tense. Yeah. I couldn't stop looking like over at her and him because I was like sitting there.
It was so funny. I couldn't hold it. I was like,
yeah. Oh my god, yeah, it was really good. It's interesting and it's kind of strange. And I don't know. I just like, if I were him, I'd feel uncomfortable watching it.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because the first scene is a bit like.
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, it was good. And oh, Echo's in it a lot. She's so cute. Yeah. She's adorable. And yeah, I think it's interesting, and I reckon if you're a fan of Aidan, like, you'll definitely love it. If you're not, then it's like you're basically watching like a whole movie of his face, so I don't think it'll be like up your street, but I definitely recommend if you're a fan. If I were to give it, how much would you give it out of 5?
5? 4.5?
Yeah, it was really good. I'll give it a 4. And that's as a non-biased fan, so. First film of London Film Festival, done and dusted. Thumbs up from me.